Our last and fifth Dr. Honoris Causa I will introduce now. The Board of Deans of Maastricht University, on the recommendation of its faculties and after consultation with the University Council, has decided to award an honorary doctorate to Professor Jürgen Hennig in recognition of his outstanding achievements. I invite Professor Rainer Goebel, whom the Board of Deans appointed as his supervisor, to fulfill the duty he has been charged with.
Jürgen Hennig is one of the pioneers of magnetic resonance imaging. He studied chemistry in Stuttgart, London, Munich, and Freiburg from 1969 to 1977. In 1980, he received his doctoral degree from the University of Freiburg on NMR measurements of intramolecular exchange kinetics. In 1989, he finished his postdoctoral lecture qualification at the Medical Faculty of the University of Freiburg. In 2004, he was appointed full professor at the University Medical Center Freiburg, and since then, he is the scientific director of the Department of Diagnostic Radiology. With an awarded ERC Advanced Investigators Grant, he is currently developing ultra-fast magnetic resonance imaging for applications in the fields of neurology, oncology, and the neurosciences. His academic, intellectual, and professional leadership is wide-ranging, as indicated by numerous international awards and his presidentship of the International Society of Magnetic Resonance in Medicine in 1999.
Jürgen Hennig is a giant, and I mean not that he is so tall. I mean he is a giant in magnetic resonance imaging. He's one of the pioneers of that technology, which is now in all hospitals around the world. And he is especially recognized internationally for establishing MRI for clinical diagnostics. Jürgen Hennig, I asked myself, where does his fame come from? This has many reasons, but I will focus on his first major discovery. This was the development of the RAIR MRI pulse sequence. RAIR stands for Rapid Acquisition with Relaxation Enhancement. Through his work, the MR image acquisition time could be significantly reduced, which constituted an important step for its use in clinical routine. The RAIR method was first published in 1984 in the German journal Der Radiologe. Why I'm saying that is the following. His first submission to an international journal was rejected. And I told you this is now in all scanners worldwide used. It was rejected with the comment that this method has already been tested and wouldn't work. Finally, in the year 1986, international publications followed, and RAIR is currently one of the standard methods used in clinical MRI scanners. The method is also known by other acronyms like TSE, Turbo Spin Echo, and FSE, Fast Spin Echo. Since the mid-80s, Jürgen Hennig also established strong connections to Asia. He has, for example, set up one of the first MRI systems in China in 85. He is honorary member of the Chinese Radiological Society and member of the Academy of Science of the Republic of Tatarstan. Furthermore, he maintains collaborations with Hong Kong, South Korea, and Singapore. He received numerous awards, I will mention only a few, including the Max Planck Research Award in 2003 in the category of Biosciences and Medicine. In 2010, he received the Tsung Ming II Award, which is the highest scientific award of Taiwan. He was also twice invited to give the prestigious Sir Peter Mansfield Nobel Lecture of the International Society for Magnetic Resonance in Medicine. His colleagues told me that he was very proud about a special award, which was the nomination of the Einstein Professor of the Chinese Academy of Science in 2011. With his awarded ERC Investigators Grant, he is currently developing ultra-fast magnetic resonance imaging for applications in various fields and also in basic neuroscience and clinical applications. And that's also a link to our collaboration here in the future with him. Jürgen is a brilliant scientist and a visionary, unconventional thinker. He nonetheless is a very modest person. When asked how he had invented the RAIR sequence, he replied, I did not have much of a feeling of being inventive. I was just applying what I had learned about spin physics during my days in physical chemistry to the task at hand. Therefore, by the authority vested on me by law and in conformity with the decision of the Board of Deans, I hereby confer upon you, Jürgen Hennig, the degree of Doctor Honoris Causa and all the rights deriving therefrom by law and tradition. As evidence of this, I present to you the degree certificate signed by the Rector, the Dean of the Faculty of Psychology and Neuroscience, and myself, and affixed with the great seal of the university, and I put on your shoulders the kappa, which signifies the honor bestowed upon you.
Professor Hennig.
I'm extremely honored and moved and delighted to receive this doctorate from Maastricht University. Over the last 2 days, I had the opportunity to have a look at this rapidly developing campus, at the excellent facilities made available to the top scientists, and most of all, by the spirit of innovation pervading the whole campus. I want to congratulate Maastricht University for following the policy not to do everything like everybody else, but to really focus on key areas to attract international leading scientists like Rainer Goebel to really make a difference in key fields. I'm a medical physicist, as you heard. Rainer's a neuroscientist. I try to make spins work to put some use into diagnostic and also research. And by having Rainer as a sponsor of this, this gives me a little bit the feeling that some of the efforts have not been totally in vain. So I want to thank the university, the rector, the board of deans, and of course, most of all, Rainer for this honor. This really means a lot to me. Thank you very much.